Monday. It's the start of a new weekly vlog. Welcome. It's currently 1 p.m. in the afternoon, and you guys may be like, hey, Galen, why aren't you working? What's up? Why are you home? It's Labor Day, so I'm off work today. Thank you, Labor Day, for the paid day off. Love it. So I have done some things this morning. I haven't really talked to you guys, but I have done B-roll. So I am currently exporting my weekly vlog, which is last week's vlog, so go watch that. And I'm just doing all the content computer worky bits that I need to do today because I am treating this as a work day, but a content work day, which is fine. I like these content work days because I much prefer content work over my real job. So yeah, but let's talk about some reading things and what's going on this week. Currently, I'm reading one physical book, one ebook, and listening to a book. There's a bunch of book content going on. So for physical book, I am reading The 5-Star Weekend. This I'm kind of just picking up when I want a break from my other two books. I'm filming a secret video that I am not going to talk about. I'm going to mention the books, but I'm not going to talk about what the video is about or anything like that. So I really am prioritizing those books this month, but when my brain needs a break from those books, because the books are not books I normally read, so that's why I just want this book to kind of like break it up. I am 43 pages into this book and I do really like it. So for my ebook, I'm reading My Year of Rest and Relaxation, and I'm 40% of the way through, almost done with this book. And that's all I'm going to say about it because this book is for my secret video. As of my audiobook, I just started it this morning when I was cleaning. Let me see how far I'm into this book. I'm only 4% of the way through this book and I'm 51 minutes in, and I am listening to Dune, which this book has kind of been on my radar for a while. I have always been curious about the movie since it was announced and then it came out, and I watched the movie like a month ago, I think, and was left confused but intrigued. So I wanted to read this book, and then when I decided to do this video project, this book just happens to be on the TBR, so I was like, oh, perfect. So this morning I saw that it was on my library available for audio, and I was like, let me just listen to it on audio. And I am really liking this book. This is a very immersive audiobook. It has sound effects, it's got a full cast of characters, it's so good, and I think that's one of the reasons why I'm so just intrigued and hooked for this book. Now being so little into the book when I have so much more to go, but I think this book is gonna be a really good book for me. So yeah, those are all my reading plans. As far as week plans, this is my week. I do work Friday, so unfortunately I do work Friday. Saturday and Sunday I don't have much planned, which is fine for me because you know me, I'm an introvert. So yeah, I don't really have any other plans at all for the rest of the week, which is fine with me. So that's it. I am gonna go back to doing some content work, and then we're gonna have lunch and I'll probably read or something. I don't know, but you guys are coming along with me, so let's go make a thumbnail, which is arguably my favorite part of content creating. Okay, goodbye. This is what we got going on with the thumbnail. I'm not in love with it, but it's what I'm working with. Didn't really take much content pics this week, so I don't know, I'm not in love with it, but what am I gonna do? You know? Look how cute these shoes are. I got them off Amazon. They're my fake Birkenstocks until I buy myself the real ones, but I love them. Diet Coke just disrespected me. It's still stunning. Buffalo chicken dip. This is why I love football season so much.
Because my mom makes buffalo chicken dip so often, and yes, I do take a giant container home. It's much later in the day. It's 6 o'clock, almost. It's 5 minutes till six. But I can't call them Sunday scaries because it's Monday, but the work scaries have officially set in. And I'm feeling anxious. So I'm gonna do stuff that makes me feel good. And what I'm really craving is just to sit and watch TV and thoughts it. And I kind of sat with myself for like an hour, and I realized I never just sit and watch TV. If I'm watching TV, I'm either reading, which I love reading, I do, but it's kind of now turning into work, which I never want reading to turn into work. So I need to take a step back from reading and maybe just read at night or if I really want to during the day. So that's kind of what I'm doing with reading right now. I have been listening to Dune pretty much all day when I can. And it's not because I feel like it, like I feel like I have to. It's because I kind of want to. And it was something to put in my ears while I was like doing other stuff. But yeah, I'm just going to sit and have my dinner and watch Vampire Diaries. I got into Vampire Diaries again, which I did like a month ago. Stopped watching it. And then now I'm back into it. We're at the part where Klaus has entered the chat. Klaus is into the chat room. He is not back in his original body. If you guys have watched it, you know. If not, you're probably like, what are you even talking about? So he's not back in his body yet, but he's about to be. So I'm just going to watch that for the rest of the night. And I want to show you guys my dinner because it's a dinner I make during the summer. It's like a summer dinner for me. Basically, it's barbecue chicken pizza with corn. Let me show you. Nothing fancy. But I'm all about quick, easy, relatively healthy meals. Not that this is probably not the healthiest thing for you, but it's better than me buying like a large pizza from Donato's. Oh my God, you guys don't. I keep forgetting that Donato's is like not an all over pizza chain. I think it's just an Ohio thing. So if you guys have a Donato's in your state, let me know. Because I'm pretty sure it's just an Ohio thing. But Donato's is so good. Anyways, let me show you. Pizza, basically it's just on a Greek, what is this called, pita? It's pita with some chicken thighs that I baked in barbecue sauce, a little bit of cheese and drizzle of honey and then corn and a Diet Coke and then Vampire Diaries. So I'll probably just leave the camera today. If I record anything, it'll be B-roll. So if I don't talk to you for the rest of the day, I will talk to y'all tomorrow, hopefully, depending on how work goes. Now that I'm clean, I'm never gonna risk it. The drought was the very worst. This is not, I don't know what this look is. Listen, it's Tuesday. It's, oh my God, excuse me. It is technically a Monday in the working world. So today was first day back to work after being off for 4 days and it was miserable. It's late, it's 8:20. Why am I still up and the lights are still up in my house and I'm not in bed? Because I got re-addicted to Vampire Diaries. Listen, I've been watching it very casually, very slowly while it's on the background. Well, last night, I just hit season 3. Season 3. And, you know, if you've watched it, you know, Klaus has entered the chat. And this is when things get exciting. And this is also the time when she chooses the right brother. If you're on the same team, I love you. If you're on the other team, you're okay. I'm just kidding. You like who you like. You can obviously tell what my taste in men are like. Tommy Shelby, Damon Salvatore. Do I need to go on? No, we don't need to dive into that right now. Okay, so let's talk reading. So first let's do a haul because I got book of the month. I got two books. And one was a monthly pick and the one I've had on hold for my library for weeks. And it was like an insane, I think it said it was like I forget how many weeks, but essentially it was like a 4 month wait. And I was like, ah, girl, and Book of the Month had this book. And now I'm being very careful with my spending in September. August was fun. August was like a fun trial that just didn't work out. So we're really doing it in September. Essentially it was only $11 versus $30. So, okay, first book I got was The Intern by Michelle Campbell, and it says a young Harvard law student falls under the spell of a charismatic judge in this timely and thrilling novel about class, ambition, family, and murder. Dun dun dun. I'm not gonna read the summary because it's a thriller. So when I read this, I'll let y'all know what's up. And the second book I got, I'm gonna butcher the name, so let me Google how this name is said. Vampires of Il Norte. I'm so American. I'm so sorry. This book with this gorgeous color. Cover. Oh my God. I read, was it The Hacienda? Yeah, The Hacienda. Oh my God. That book was so good. So I knew when I was looking for releases of this year, I typed this author because I have a list of authors that I save on my Notion of who to look out for their next releases. She was one of them. And I mean, vampires. I don't exactly know what this book is about. I just know it has vampires. So I said, oh, yeah, it's on the end. So I'm not going to go over what it says because that's a long summary, y'all. And I'm just not quite feeling up to it. So there's the summary if you want to pause. Or I will link it down below. I'm in a weird mood. I'm very sorry. I don't know why I'm acting this way. This is me. When I'm trying to overconfiscate, this is me when I'm trying to forget about something that's making me anxious. So like I become Dululu. So this is me in my Dululu state. So actual reading updates. I listened to Dune. I'm not gonna talk about it because that's for another video, but I just wanted to update you guys where I'm at in Dune. So I am 17% in 3 hours in, and I'm 17 hours to go in this audiobook. I am listening to it on 1x speed because this is an audiobook that is so cool and immersive and just, oh my God, I love it so much. Also, can we talk about Timothée Chalamet and Kylie Jenner? Y'all, I was heartbroken. But also, I just want to know what they talk about. Anyone else? Like, I just want to know what do they speak about. Like, I need to hear their conversations. Like, I just need to. Because those are just two people I wouldn't mash together. But then I saw a video of them being all cutesy and lovey-dovey. I'm like, oh my God, they look so cute together. So, I don't know. Anyone else? What's your feelings on it? I would love to know. So, that's that on Dune. On the other book that I am reading for that video that I'm absolutely hating. So if you're hating a book, don't be like me and don't push through it. Only reason I'm pushing through it is because I'm doing a video on it. Don't, if you're hating a book, DNF it. DNF the book. I am 53% of the way through. I have an hour and 54 minutes left of this book. So I would love to finish this book by tomorrow night, but I don't think it's going to happen because that means I'd have to read either for an hour tonight in 54 minutes tomorrow or flip-flop it. Or, you know what, we'll see. We'll see. And then the five-star weekend, I didn't get far into this because you know what I did last night? Instead of reading and not going on my phone, because one of my goals is to not go on my phone an hour before bed, and I was bad and I turned on Vampire Diaries. And you know what time? You know what time I ended up going to bed? After midnight. That's why I'm like this right now. So mad at myself for doing that. So that's pretty much all the updates. I think I'm gonna take a break from this. Unfortunately finish this because I really need to get a roll on that TBR because we have a lot more to go for this TBR. And when I'm finished with this TBR, one of these will be read. Probably the vampire one. So that's it. That's what I wanted to say. I'm gonna go probably, what time is it? Oh, yep. I'm gonna go hop into bed, read. Even though all I wanna do is watch one more episode of The Vampire. You know what? I'm gonna let myself watch until 9 o'clock of The Vampire Diaries because my teeth are brushed, my skincare is done. So I'm gonna watch until 9 o'clock and then we're gonna get into bed. Does that sound like a deal? That sounds like a deal to me. Okay. Okay. Let's go watch The Vampire Diaries because I just want to see Damon Salvatore. Okay. Toodaloo.
How long it took for us to set all this up?
Forgot about senior prank night, huh?
We're about to be seniors. These are the memories that will stay with us forever. And I love you.
Get the faculty toilet seats in Danny's mind. You are supposed to be dead.
I realized I haven't picked up the camera at all today except for B-roll, so hello. It is now Wednesday. I thought it was Thursday. I was about to be really excited, but it's Wednesday. That's okay. It's been a long day, so that's that. We're forgetting about the work day. We're moving on because it's the evening time. Actually, it's almost the night. It's 7 o'clock, 7:40. And I've just been sitting here reading my year of rest and relaxation. I'm now an hour and 24 minutes away from ending this book, which thank God. but no, I just wanted to hop on here real quick, say, hey, how y'all doing? Yeah, that's pretty much all the updates I have for you today. We're almost done with the week, guys. Halfway through the week. Okay, that's it. I will chat to y'all when I do. I made Rice Krispie treats. So good. It is Friday. It's 7:50 in the morning and I unfortunately do work today. I could cry. But I decided to vlog because Olivia Rodrigo's new album just came out and I totally, fake fan, totally forgot it came out today. So I kind of want to give it a listen. It's called Guts. So let's All American bitch. Okay, let's just shuffle it. is going to my You're My Kryptonite playlist. And no, I will not reveal what, when, where, why that playlist is about. But just know it's called You're My Kryptonite for a reason. Heartbreaking song. Let's go next. Making the Bed. All right, first impressions, stunning. Like, holy crap. She's done it again. I can't wait to listen to the rest of this. So by the end of the day, I will make sure to tell you guys what my favorite songs are off the album, but yeah. So I gotta finish my coffee and go to work. I have a half day today, so I should be home by like noon. Fingers crossed, I don't know, we'll see. So it's not terrible, but it's something that I would rather not go and do because I have so much content stuff to do. And I didn't even talk to you guys yesterday because it was just a long day and I was really tired. I filmed some B-roll. I just didn't feel like talking, so sorry. But I started my edit on my September reset and I was very nervous about this video because one, the day I filmed it was not my best day. And thankfully, it doesn't come across in the footage. Like, thankfully, you guys cannot tell that I was not having it. Acting skills. No, it was just my first day of, like, the period. It was starting. It hadn't started, but it was, like, that first day that it was gonna start. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And I was cranky. Everything was irritating me. Nothing was going right. And then I had a section in the vlog where I was gonna decorate for fall. And then found out all my fall decor is gone because I threw it away. Because it was decor I shared with an old roommate of mine, and I just didn't want to have any remembrance of that life, so I threw it all away, forgot I did that. So that kind of disappointed me, and I felt like I disappointed you guys, so... But thankfully, like, you can't really tell that in the vlog and the rest of the footage, so yeah, I edited a lot of that yesterday. I'm going back and doing final touches today, but I'm really excited about how it's turning out. So, okay, I'm gonna finish my coffee and then sadly go to work, but I will see you guys when I get home. Hi! Same position that I talked to you guys earlier today, but I am home from work. It's much, much later. It's like 7 o'clock at night. I just got some dinner. I ordered dinner tonight. I never order dinner. Y'all know me. Don't ever order dinner, but I had a really hard week. And I was at work a lot longer than I thought I was going to be. So I said, you know what? Let's get food. So I'm going to show you what I got. Pizza from Donato's. If you don't have Donato's, I feel sorry for you. And wings. Because I couldn't decide between both. So pizza and wings go so good together. And I'm going to watch Vampire Diaries. And that's going to be my night. And I will update you guys at some point tonight about my reading. So let me go enjoy my dinner though first. As a Damon girl, I am so happy we finally have reached this moment. Let's sit down and have a proper chat, shall we? We shall. Hello guys, it is now Friday at 9 o'clock at night. I have spoken to you guys today. I forgot about that. I have spoken to you guys. I've spoken to you guys this morning, which Olivia Rodrigo, her new album, so good. I like The Grudge the best. That song just hits me right here. Just stares me in the heart, you know? So I'm really liking that. That's up to you about my day. I worked, came home, cleaned my entire house, which felt so good. You know that saying, tidy house, tidy mind? It's so true. And I never knew it until I lived on my own. And I was like, I can definitely tell when I'm more anxious and just like uptight and just like all over the place. It's because my house is not tidy. And so like now I feel very just
ready to go into the weekend with a fresh, clean house. So, yes. But let's talk reading updates. So, I'm still reading My Year of Rest and Relaxation. I have 40 minutes left of this book, you guys, and I'm finishing it tonight. I have to finish it tonight. And then I started Abby Jimenez, Yours Truly, I believe. Hold on, let me go to my Kindle app. Sometimes it's just easier to look at my progress on my phone versus my Kindle, because my Kindle is so slow. So I'm only 7% into this book on page 24. I don't know much. I know we're following, what's his name? So we're following Jacob and Brianna. We're getting two different POVs, which we love. And both of them work at the same hospital, and they're both in running to be chief of the emergency department. I don't know the correct, like, title of that job. But Jacob comes across as a Mr. Know-it-all, and Brianna has been there for, like, 10 years, and she was a shoo-in for the job, and then the chief of the hospital was like, no, like, I'm gonna give him a chance. So she's, like, all, like, been out of shape about it. And both of them have just come out of, like, a very heartbreaking situation. Brianna's husband cheated on her, and then Jacob's ex-girlfriend is marrying his brother. So both of them are, like, very much heartbroken, came from very, like, kind of messed up relationships in a way. And I'm thinking they're gonna bond over that, and they're gonna get together. And then it's setting up like it's gonna be a fake dating trope, because Jacob told his family that, like, he's fine with his ex-girlfriend Amy and Jeremiah, which is his brother, like, getting married. He's fine because he's moved on, when he really hasn't been in a new relationship. Like, he's still single. So I'm guessing he's gonna, like, date her, or, like, fake date her. So that's pretty much where I'm at in the book. I'm really liking it so far. I really like Abby Jimenez's writing. And then I have been listening to Dune literally all day. And this book, listen, I'm 7 hours and 58 minutes in this book, and I still have 13 hours left of this audiobook. And I'm guessing the movie that we got out of this, did they split up in two parts? Can someone tell me that? Because how did this entire book translate on screen to be 2 hours and 32 minutes? This book is a 21-hour book. Can someone tell me? Because I don't understand. Unless they cut a lot of things, which I think they did. But I am really liking it a lot. It's definitely a book that I have to really pay attention to what I'm listening to so I can really absorb it, but still really liking it. Hopefully gonna finish it by the end of the month. But on the rate, I listened to it for the first week, basically 8 hours in the first week I had it. So there's all of my reading updates. I'm going to finish My Year of Rest and Relaxation. Have Vampire Diaries on the background, which we just got to the part in Vampire Diaries that Damon has entered the chat. If you know, you know. So there's that. I'm gonna go do all these things, and I probably won't update you guys until tomorrow, or maybe if I finish this book, I'll let you know. Actually, no, because that's for a different vlog. I forgot. So yeah, I'm not gonna talk to you guys until tomorrow. So until then, goodbye. Believe it or not, 2 hours have gone by since that last clip you saw, and I'm still here. So, good morning, guys. It's now 11:30.
8:30 almost the afternoon, and I have just edited this vlog up until this point, and I ticked one thing off of my to-do list, so it feels good. The next thing I need to do is get ready for the day because I got some short form content to film, and I also have to take some thumbnails, so I have to get ready. I mean, I don't have to, but like, I kind of want to look presentable today. And it's Saturday, so happy Saturday. Last night, I actually did end up finishing my year of rest and relaxation. I gave it 1 star. Absolutely did not like that book at all. But I'll talk more about that in my video that I'm doing. I almost spoiled it. So, yeah, that's done. I feel really good about that. I read some of Yours Truly by Abby Jimenez last night, and I am really liking this book. It's a very quick read, which I really do appreciate. And our main character, well, one of our main characters, the main male, like, love interest, he has anxiety. And it's really refreshing to read about a man having anxiety, because typically in romance books or any sort of book that revolves around like a man and a woman and having a relationship, the woman is the one that typically has anxiety. And I don't understand why we do that. I don't understand, like, men can have anxiety too. Like, and I don't know if it's to make us seem like quote unquote weak or we need help or someone save, you know, that mentality that society has put on us women that I fucking hate. I don't need no man ever. I'd be fine by myself for the rest of my life. Okay, so it's really nice to read a book that has the man as the person with anxiety, and also it's accurate, which is very good. We had a scene where he was talking about why he doesn't drink, which was really nice because I also don't really drink. I don't partake in alcohol anymore. I used to, and maybe one day I'll go into it, but I don't really feel the need to or the want to kind of explain myself, which no one should have to explain themselves why they don't drink. You should just be able to be like, I don't drink. I don't want to say that I will never drink again. I will drink when there's a special occasion, so probably when I turn 30, I'll probably have a glass of wine, because cheers, Kaylin, you made it 30 years in your life, and you made it through some of the hardest years, and this next decade is going to be the best years of your life, so that's probably when I'll have a glass of wine, and I'll probably have a glass of wine when I'm on vacation in the cabin, but other than that, yeah. So anyways, back to the book. So it was really nice to read about that, and also he mentioned that before he goes places, he checks the menu, he checks the location, he checks the parking situation, which I do that too, so it's very nice to read about that and relate to a character. Even though the character is a man, there's still stuff that I can relate to with him. So yeah, I read a couple chapters of that. Let me see where I'm at in that book now. I'm now 41 pages into it, and there's 400 pages, so I still have a little bit to go, a little ways to go, so I'm liking that. Haven't listened anymore to Dune today. And there is a new audiobook that I'm going to start for this other video, and that is 84 Charing Cross Road. I tried to get it on, like, through my library on Kindle, and the version they had was Spanish, and I clicked on it. It didn't click until I opened my Kindle app, and I was like, wait a second, what? So I have the audiobook. The audiobook's only 2 hours long, so I can finish that quickly, which is nice. So those were kind of all my reading updates. Let's go put on some makeup and get ready for the day and film and be productive. So let's go. Here is the OOTD, very comfy casual. Oh my God, she's back with makeup. The world is shocked. Sound the alarms. Hey guys, it's now 1 o'clock in the afternoon. I've done all of like my filming, taking pictures, stuff I need to do. So I just have to edit a thumbnail and then get my September reset video scheduled. So I'm gonna do that
right now. And also, football's on the TV. Let me show y'all. Let me show you guys. Not that any of you guys care, because I know a lot of people just don't care. But football's on the TV. I have it muted. So, there's football. It's on the TV. We're playing Youngstown today. And yeah, so I'm going to make this thumbnail really quickly, schedule this vlog, and then we're going to get some, what is going on? And then we're going to get some lunch and kind of chill out for the rest of the day. I do have to bake some cookies because, okay, I'm not technically done filming because I'm filming my movie night vlog, which I need to do research. We're watching When Harry Met Sally, I think. I put a poll up on Instagram, so let me see. Yeah, When Harry Met Sally. So I'm guessing we're gonna watch When Harry Met Sally, so I have to do some research on that film because I like to have it. And yeah, so we're filming that. And then also I'm gonna film like a cozy fall night type thing for TikTok. Not like a day in my life vlog, just like a little like aesthetically pleasing me cooking the cookies and then like watching Harry Met Sally, When Harry Met Sally. So stuff like that. So that's what I'm gonna do. But for right now, we're going to do the last of our computer work and I will chat with y'all later. Baking some cookies for a TikTok video, and I wish you guys could smell these because these smell delicious. This is potentially going to be a dessert I bring to the cabin because I was instructed to be bringing desserts and cookies and stuff like that. So potentially this could be it, but this is all the ingredients. And when they're done, I'll be sure to update you guys how they are, but I just wanted to update you guys that I am baking. If you guys want to see like the full thing, make sure to follow me on TikTok because it will be posted. This is what they look like before. Not the prettiest things in the world, but I think they're going to be delicious. In the oven they go for like 12 to 15 minutes. I'm going to check them at 12 minutes. So, see y'all in 12 minutes. Hello guys, let me pause this. I am now baking the first batch of cookies and I'm having a little midday coffee. I allow myself to have midday coffees on the days I don't have to get up for work the next day. Caffeine really affects me. I get a lot of anxiety from caffeine sometimes, but also I literally, like, it prevents me from going to sleep. So, well, like, on a timely manner. Does that make sense? Anyone else like that? I don't know. I'm one of those lucky few people that are really affected by caffeine, and I hate it because I love coffee. And I need to just get decaf coffee to have, like, in the evenings because I love the taste, and I just love the cozy, comfy, that's the same thing. But you know that feeling you get from holding, like, a warm cup of coffee? Oh, my God, it's the best. But I'm actually going to sit down and do some reading of Yours Truly. I really want to get more into this book. While my cookies are baking, I figured it's the perfect time because I'm going to have a lot of batch of cookies, which is great because I will be able to take some to my parents' house when I see them next, which will probably be next weekend. I'm going to stay home this weekend, which I never really just stay home and not go see them. So it's really weird to be home on a Saturday. But that's what I'm gonna do, and I thought I would just pop in and update you guys instead of just like inserting B-roll and you guys be like, okay, what is she doing now? So let's get to reading. Let's go check the cookies. I'm so excited to see how these turned out. Let me see. Oh my God. Perfect. Hang on.
I have to grab my phone and record a TikTok clip of this, but hang on. I'll update you guys in a sec.
You guys, look at these cookies. They're so like cake-like. I'm so excited to have them. Like, so excited.
All right, I have a cookie here. We're gonna try it. It's very cake-like. Do you see that? It's gonna be so hot. Okay. I think if you don't like super sweet desserts, definitely for you. And if you like more like spongy, cakey desserts, definitely for you. If you like pumpkin bread, for you. I'm more of a pumpkin roll girl. Like, I love the cream cheese icing. So I feel like these would be so good if it had a very thin layer of cream cheese icing. Still very good. Highly recommend. Hello guys. I realize you can probably hear my microwave and I'm very sorry about that. And I don't know why I'm choosing to update you guys now and not wait until it's done. I have no rhyme or reason. But I just wanted to let you guys know that I'm 25% of the way through Yours Truly by Abby Jimenez. And I'm really liking this a lot, you guys. So let me further explain what's going on. Brianna and Jacob have both come from situations that have broken their heart. Brianna is dealing with some family stuff. Her brother is going into kidney failure, or he is in kidney failure. Basically, he needs a kidney transplant, and he's got a super rare blood type that is basically impossible to get a match from. And her brother is just spiraling, going into depression. I mean, who could blame him? Right? So she's taking on the role of being the mother and like taking him into her house. And then we have Jacob, who their first interaction, well, basically she runs into him, breaks his phone. She doesn't know that though. And then later on, they both get in the supply closet, both by just separate occasions. She goes in there to kind of relieve some stress. He goes in there because he's just feeling overwhelmed. And then they have this like whole tiff. And then a couple days later, she basically gives him a tip like, hey, bring cupcakes to the nurses. This nurse likes this and blah, 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 because like he's not getting on the good side of nurses. And someone told her to be nice to him because he's like the nicest guy ever. And so he does, and he ends up writing her a letter basically explaining he didn't mean to come off so rude and insensitive about her brother. He's got social anxiety and sometimes he doesn't pick up on social cues, and he basically explains he's not good with like social stuff and he's very anxious and all that sort of stuff. And honestly, this letter was like so heartwarming. Immediately fell in love with him. Immediately I was into it. Okay, and so Brianna writes him back and they end up exchanging notes to each other, which is so cute. What is it about a letter versus texting that is just so much better? Like, it's so much better. I think because you have to put actual time and thought into it, because with texting you can like text and delete it and text again. Like, letter, you have to be like, what's the word, you have to be intentional with your words and what you're saying, or else you have to start all over again. And it's just really cute. And they begin to form like this kind of like friendship, and then they end up following each other on Instagram. And when before like he accepted her friend request, he like got really nervous about it because he's like, only my closest people have the access to this account because this is like the realest, rawest me, and on and on and on. And so he accepts it, and then she's like, hey, can I call you? Immediately I felt anxious, and so did he. That would have spiraled me. I don't like phone calls. I don't like calling people. I don't like FaceTiming. Like, I don't like any of that. It makes me so anxious. And so he was like immediately like, oh my God. And I was like, yeah, I get it, bro. I get it. So they end up having a phone call, and that's basically where I'm at in the story. And he has a Bernese Mountain Dog named Lieutenant Dan. He's got three legs. He rescued him. And he also has a cabin, and this all takes place in Minnesota. And I'm like, oh my God, I'm in love with this man. So this book is doing one thing that is usually a big ick for me, and it's mentioning real life stuff. So it's mentioned TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, all that stuff, and I'm like, ugh, like part of me is like, ew, ick, like stop, like I don't want to mention it, but it's kind of working for this story. So that's why I'm out in the book. And I am really liking it. I don't know how much I will read anymore tonight because I'm about to have my dinner and I'm going to turn on Vampire Diaries for a little bit. And then we're having a movie night tonight because we are watching When Harry Met Sally, and I'm so excited. I actually researched some facts, which I'll talk about when I get closer to the movie night. But yeah, that's kind of all I wanted to say, catch you guys up on. And I will talk to y'all later. It's movie night time. I'm so excited. Here's the setup.
As always, same setup.
I will tell you more in a second. Let me get situated.
I know this lighting sucks and I'm so sorry, but tonight's movie night, we are watching When Harry Met Sally, and I'm so excited. I've actually never seen this film, but when looking up like fall films, this was the one that everyone was like, this is a fall film, and like the film poster is fall, okay? Like fall. So let me tell you some fun facts. It was directed by Rob Reiner, who also directed Sleepless in Seattle and Wolf of Wall Street, which I had no idea. And this came out in 1989. And there's interludes throughout the film of like how we met, and those couples that are telling those stories are real couples. Like, those are real stories, which I thought was super cute. Harry and Sally were actually modeled after Rob, who was the director, and Nora, who is the screenwriter. Their relationship, minus being in love, because they weren't in love. So that's kind of cool. Molly Ringwald was almost casted to play Sally, but due to like scheduling conflicts, she couldn't. She declined, which I love Molly Ringwald. There's a famous line that is said by a older woman in the film, and it goes, I'll have what she's having, and it's actually Rob's mother saying it. Billy Crystal, who plays Harry, actually improvised throughout this entire movie. So I'm really excited to see that and see how his acting is, because I don't think I've ever watched a film with him in it. I know who he is. Or maybe I have and I just haven't realized it. The bookstore that's featured in this movie is a real bookstore, and it actually inspired Nora when filming You've Got Mail. So yeah, those are all my little fun facts. So now I'm gonna go update my movie vlog that I'm doing over on TikTok, and then we will start the film together. I'm really excited to just have like a really chill, nice film, because I've been watching like dramatic films for the past couple weeks, so it's gonna be nice to have something like a romantic comedy to kind of spice things up. I really want to buy this game, but it's $60, which makes me so incredibly sad that this game is $60. I wish Nintendo Switch games weren't that expensive. Yeah, because I haven't picked up my Switch in a long time, and it's not because I don't want to. I've just been kind of bored with the games I have, and I think it's because I've had them for like over a year now, and I'm like, okay, it's time for a Switch up. So I was thinking about that, or there's another game that I really, really want. Hang on, let me find it.
Or I want this one. But again, $50. I don't know. Maybe next paycheck, I'll treat myself. I ended up buying a new cozy game, and I bought Lemon Cakes. I've seen a lot about Lemon Cakes. I've heard it described as like Cooking Mama, but lower stakes. And then I watched the trailer and I was like, oh, perfect. So it scratched the itch for a new game, which is cool. And it was only $15. It was half off. So if you guys are watching this and you want Lemon Cakes, go check your Nintendo store because it could still be half off. I don't know how long it'll be half off, but yeah. So I'm going to play that. It's right there. I played a little bit of Stardew, but you know, I do like Stardew a lot. I just go in ways with it. Like, I think it's super cozy and all that, and you can do pretty much whatever you want on it. But I wanted something different. And then Disney Valley. I feel like I played so much when it first came out and when I first got my Switch that I literally burnt myself out of it, and I haven't even got on it for so long. So yeah, and then you guys know my thoughts on Zelda, so Lemon Cake will like make it very different. I really want to get one of those two games I told you guys about someday soon, so we'll see. But I do have reading updates, and I haven't said hello like properly. So hello, it's now Sunday. I'm really proud of myself because I didn't want to go for a walk by the water. I was having a little bit of anxiety leaving my house and going and doing that. But I said, you know what, Kaylin, do it. You'll just be like, it'll start your day off in a good way. So I'm really glad I did that. I did it. You guys saw a little bit of footage. It was not busy. Like, usually, if you go during the summer, like summer mornings, there's so many people that go there. This morning there was maybe like, I don't know, 10 people, which isn't a lot because this walking, like the bridge that you walk on, the little walking bridge, is really big. And so like, yeah, it was really nice to kind of have just space when walking, because sometimes you're like constantly passing people, and I don't mind it, but I just kind of like to be on my own when walking. I don't know. Does that make sense? So yeah, it was really nice, really lovely. And I continue to remind myself that I am so lucky and grateful for where I live, because I can drive 5 minutes and go walk that. No, it's not the ocean and not some like wonderful lake or anything like that, but it's still a body of water, and it still puts my mind at ease and helps my anxiety. So one day, and I don't care if I'm 50, 60, 70, I will live along the coast. That is my goal in life, is to live along the coast. If I could do it now and take my parents with me, I totally would. Like, if I won the lottery, I would pack up all my stuff, pack up all my parents, pay off their bills first, like all their bills, and I would buy us like a big house and down on the coast and just live. That's kind of what I would do. I always think about that. But yeah, so I did that, and while I did that, I listened to Dune, and I also did my Sunday reset. Also, you probably just heard the air conditioning kick on. I have my windows open, so it's my neighbor's air conditioning. So sorry if you can hear that, which I'm actually gonna shut my windows pretty soon because I think the breeze has stopped. It's only 72 out, so it's really cool, which we love it. Okay, anyways, so Dune, I am now 47% into this, and I have 11 hours to go. So we're getting there. I'll hopefully finish it in the next vlog, which is exciting. And then for my physical reading, I read some last night after watching When Harry Met Sally, which I will talk about in a second. I am now 31% into this book, and I am still really liking it. So there's that for my reading updates. I am going to catch up on BookTube because I have so many videos to catch up on, and play some Lemon Cake, and I'm really excited, and then have some lunch. I don't know if I'm going to read anymore today, maybe tonight, but I don't think I'm going to finish this book, which is okay, because I at least finished one book and I'm making progress on my video project that I'm doing. So I'm good with that. So I'm gonna do all these things and take you guys along with me. So come on, let's go. This is pretty much how I feel, okay? I'm really, really, really anxious. Y'all already know it's Sunday. Sunday scaries have hit me full force because it is now 5 o'clock in the evening. So what I'm gonna do for the rest of the evening is have dinner and watch Vampire Diaries because 14 years ago today, Vampire Diaries released, which I didn't know that. TikTok alerted me. So I think it's only right if I spend the rest of my day watching Vampire Diaries. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do. And probably play Lemon Cakes as well and then read tonight. But I just want to say goodbye to you here because I'm going to end the vlog, because if y'all been here for a while, you know I end my vlogs 5 o'clock on Sundays so I can kind of unwind and have the rest of the day to just be with me and not have to focus on filming. Because even though it may seem easy pulling out the camera to film, you still have to like think about the shot you're getting and like, oh my God, I have to vlog. So I just allow myself to have a little bit of time to not even think about that. So that's exactly what I'm doing. But thank you guys for watching. I love you so much. Remember to be kind to yourself and to others around you. And I will see you guys in the next video. So, bye.